Hello. Let me welcome you once again to this introductory Management Information Systems course. I am indeed very happy that you have joined this course. However, may I ask, why did you join it? Why did you join a course on Management Information Systems? What do you think a Management Information System is? And thus, what shall we be covering in this course? Please don't get me wrong, I am delighted that you join us in this course, and actually in the next video I will try to convince you that you can substantially benefit from improving your understanding of management information systems, as hopefully you will by following this course. Right now, however, why don't we devote some time to ensure that we have a shared vision of what management information systems are and how do they relate to computer tools and to the more general environment of information and communication technologies, or ICTs.
Hey, wait a minute. Are you saying that information and communication technologies, ICTs, are not the same as computer tools and management information systems? What's the difference? Aren't we going to cover ICTs in this course?
Good question. Yes. We shall discuss ICTs, since management information systems are based on them. But these three concepts are not synonyms, as I will try to explain now. Before that, however, I would like to turn the tables and fire the question back at you. Could I ask you to pause the video for a minute and think about what the difference is between information and communication technologies, computer tools, and management information systems could be, as well as their relationships? Could you think of a few examples? Well, I hope your reflection aroused your interest. Let me now try to address this question. In the introductory video, we claimed, as we shall further develop in subsequent videos, that the information and communication technologies computer jungle, computers, smartphones, networks, fueled by the breakneck pace of technological progress, has stormed our society, invading both our professional and our personal or social life. We then suggested that this ICT jungle that has engulfed the world is inhabited by mysterious creatures, creatures that we must learn to live with, the information systems that guide and drive most organizations. We work in accounting, financial application will control with an iron fist how we account for transactions. If we work in sales, a system such as Salesforce.com will constantly pester us demanding data. This metaphor already hints at a key distinction. Information systems, and specifically management information systems, are supported by and live within the ICT's jungle. But they are more than merely technology. There are many definitions of management information systems, and you can find several in the supporting documentation accompanying this video. Let us, however, try to understand their key traits by looking at a few examples of management information systems that we use in our daily life. Assume you want to reserve a book from our university's library. You would enter the book's name, locate it in the book's database, identify yourself, and if authorized, mark it as reserved. Or rather, assume you would like to buy it in Amazon. You would log into Amazon's system, locate the book you want to buy, enter the required information on yourself, and carry out the purchase. Or you would like to transfer some funds from your bank account. You would log into your bank's virtual banking application and follow the steps required to instruct the system to transfer these funds to the desired destinations. Those would all be examples of information systems. And since they are business or management focused, they would be called business information systems, or more often, management information systems, the subject of this course. If you work in a company, you will easily identify a number of other management information systems that employees use in their daily tasks, such as accounting systems or manufacturing planning systems. We shall, however, not cover here other non-management information systems, such as the software governing the internal operation of an airplane or of a nuclear reactor or an electrical grid. We can see from these examples that management information systems are based on ICTs, but they are not merely technology. Computer network, smartphone, or our laptop's Windows operating system are examples of ICTs and can indeed be used by management information systems, but they are not in themselves management information systems. A less obvious distinction has to be made with computer tools, such as office tools. If we use a spreadsheet in our personal computer, we are utilizing an ICT-based tool or computer tool. However, it falls short of what we shall call here a management information system. Word processors, spreadsheets, drawing applications, and countless others are examples of general-purpose tools that can be applied to a wide variety of situations in a way decided by its user. Management information systems, however, have a predetermined structure and scope of applicability. Their design specifies which data will they utilize and how will it be processed. Management information systems lie at the frontier between information and communication technologies and business. They represent the application of ICT-based solutions to specific business requirements. In this course, we shall often resort to analogies to illustrate subtle points. An analogy could be drawn here between these computer tools and physical tools, such as a hammer, a screwdriver, or a wrench. They can be useful in assembling things, but they do not preclude how will they be used or for what. That is entirely up to the user. We could then draw an analogy between a management information system and an assembly line. Assembly lines range from very rigid to highly flexible, but they do have a certain structure. They are designed to assemble certain types of products, and there is a certain structure in how they combine and sequence operations. Modern manufacturing is heavily reliant on assembly lines, and current companies are fully dependent on the management information systems that support and structure their information flows and conform their backbone or their nervous system. In spite of the acknowledged relevance of the computer tools, such as the office tools, this course will focus on the management information systems. Thus, it will address information and communication technologies basically from the perspective of their supporting roles or their role as ingredients of the management information systems. Hopefully by now you have a clearer idea of what we mean by a management information system and how it differs from the concepts of information and communication technologies and computer tools. We'll further review it with a few questions before we move on to discuss their importance in the next video. Thank you. I hope to see you there.